Hey guys, it's Carla. Today I'm going to paint this starfish with seafoam. And I'm using an 8x10 canvas panel and acrylic paint. This is white, yellow ochre, orange, red, yellow, and cobalt blue. And the brushes I'll be using is this flat synthetic flat brush, this big synthetic angle brush, which could also be a flat brush either way. It's just to cover a large area. My deerfoot stippler, which if you don't have one, you could just use some kind of stiff bristled brush, like a hog bristle or something. And a little liner brush. All right, I'm gonna start with my large synthetic brush just to cover the whole canvas. So I'm wetting it. Always wet your synthetic brushes before you use them. All right, now I wanna cover the whole thing with sand because sand is underneath this seafoam and you can see a lot of it underneath there. So I want to paint the whole canvas that sand color, but I want the darkest shade of the sand color, which I forgot to put in because I need some brown. That's raw umber. All right. Okay, so I want the darkest color of the sand. So it's not straight brown, but it is darker than what you see. So I'm gonna pick up a little bit of brown and a little yellow ochre, maybe a touch of white. And I want to paint the entire canvas. Now the reason I'm brushing over it like this is not to smooth it out, because I don't care if it's smooth or not, because it's going to have so many layers on top of it, but I'm trying to avoid having to dry it. So this is just my lazy way of not drying it, because when you do this, it kind of spreads out the paint where there's no thick areas and it dries a lot faster. Okay, now I'm gonna use my stippler and start putting in the lighter layers. So maybe just the yellow ochre for starters. Now, I don't care now about that part under the seafoam, because that's plenty enough to show through. So I'm only concerned with this area. So actually, I'm gonna go ahead and just roughly draw in where my seafoam is gonna be. So on this part, I'm gonna use the, if you'll notice, my stippler brush has been abused, and I like it that way. Once it gets to that point, you get a better texture with it. So you might wanna intentionally abuse it a little bit. And I'm just tapping into that yellow ochre. Dabbing in this texture. Okay, so now I'm gonna pick up a little white with that yellow ochre. Be a little more sparing with this one because better you go. I mean, the lighter you go with your layers, the less you put on it, usually. Okay. Now we're gonna go lighter. Some more white to that, maybe a little yellow. Okay, now more white. This is not going to be completely white, but it's going to be very light. With my dirty brush, I'm gonna pick up just white. And just very lightly, ooh, that's too much. Wipe it on my paper towel. Just very lightly. Tap that in. And a little tip, if you start your, like when you first pick up the paint, if you'll start where your starfish is gonna be, then it'll get covered later if you end up being too bold with it. Okay. Now that I've got my sand in, I'm gonna go ahead and dry it so that I can put in my starfish and start on my water. Okay, now I'm gonna use my flat brush to, to block in my starfish. And I'm gonna start with, the starfish has some yellow, red and orange, and orange being the middle tone, I'm gonna use it to block it in. Okay, so it comes this way, up this way. I'm just looking at the angles. Okay, now there are places that has a darker orange. So I'm gonna add red to it. And this is just our base coat, so, you know, don't feel like this is how it's gonna look. But we gotta get those darker areas in there so that when we put the texture on the top, you'll be able to see this underneath. Now I'm starting to put in my texture, the shadow part of my texture, because the texture is actually lighter than the starfish, but each light area has a shadow. So I'm just tapping it in. Now I'm gonna start on my yellow. Which has a little bit white in it. So that's the underneath side of the, and a little bit of it that you're seeing underneath the starfish. And I'm not brushing this, I'm tapping it. The starfish is very rough and textured. use this light color over here. For the texture on the top. Now remember I said each of these dark areas is a shadow. So, and my light is coming from this way. So my shadow is going to be on this side, which means my highlight will be on that side of the shadow. And you could use your little detail brush for this if you need to. And on this side, my shadow is over there. So wherever you have a shadow, put the highlight on the left side. On this one, the shadow is on that side, so like on the upper side, so the highlight would be underneath it. And this one, the shadow is on the right. This one, the shadow is I guess sits more toward the top. Kind of like that one. Okay, now I am going to use my detail brush for the center because there's a lot of odd shapes there. So I'm just tapping in some highlights for texture. See a little bit of a brownish color under there. In the center. Again, I'm just tapping this in. Back with my highlights on top of it. Now I'm going to rinse my brush and really make it pop with white highlights. Now I want to go easy on this because it's not everywhere, it's just like on the highest peaks. Okay, now while that dries, I'm gonna go ahead and start layering in my seafoam. Because, let me get more white. Because it is gonna take layers, and so it's gonna have to dry some too. So I'm gonna start with my stippler and just dab off the excess. And I'm gonna start in my brightest areas so that if it gets too bright while there's a lot of paint on my brush, then it won't hurt anything. So the brightest areas would be right here, against the shore. And then as I run out of paint on my brush, I'm gonna come on back here. What I don't want to do is make everything uniform. So you want to have some areas that are like the white is kind of clumped together, and somewhere there's areas of darker. Okay, now I'm going to take that white and just the slightest little touch of the cobalt blue. Now there's areas of the white that has shadows in it, and the shadows will look blue. So just in those shadow areas, I'm just gonna tap this in. It's very subtle, but, and actually when it dries, it's gonna be a little darker, but a little less subtle, but you wanna make sure you get that in there, even though it is just a subtle color. Now some of the deeper shadows of the water are a little darker. Be careful with that blue though. It's very strong. Right around here, there's going to be a dark shade, but there's a medium shade too, and it will be a little bit darker blue and just a touch of red. So I'm gonna go right along the edge there. Tap that in. Now we need that shadow right underneath the water's edge. So I'm going to use my flat brush for that. And this is going to be blue, just a little touch of brown. And this is going to go right against the water's edge. Thank you. Okay, so I've got the thin shadow all along the edge, but in places the shadow is thicker. So I'm going to bring it out thicker in places. Okay, now while I've got that shadow color, I actually don't have it. I'm gonna have to mix some more, but I'm gonna go ahead and put the shadows for my starfish. Blue with a little touch of brown and some white. So pay attention to where your shadows are. And you can use a smaller brush if you feel more comfortable. Make sure you leave this edge jagged, because for one thing, the object that's casting the shadow is not smooth, but also the sand is not smooth, so it's gonna be a very jagged shadow, or bumpy, or... Okay, now right against the starfish is, I'm gonna have to get more paint, sorry. Right against the starfish is a really dark shadow, almost black. And blue and black, I mean blue and brown actually make a really pretty shade of black. So I'm gonna rinse my brush because it's got that lighter blue shade in it. Because I want this to be as dark as I can get it. So I'm gonna bring over some brown and some blue. Put that right against the starfish and then just let it fade off as it comes away from it. And one way to do that is use your finger to kind of smudge it out. If you're having trouble getting that gradual shade change. Okay. Don't see much over here, but just a little bit. Okay. Now, more shading on my starfish because it's dry now and I can glaze it. So to do that, I'm going to pick up some red and some water. Glaze this in where I want it to be the darkest. Okay, now we're still not finished with the water yet. But I do want to go ahead and finish my starfish. So the only other thing I'm going to do to it is I'm going to take a toothpick, which I failed to mention, and use white. And if you don't have a toothpick, just use a liner brush. But this gives me like those really bright highlights on my starfish. And they're just little dots. Okay. Now there's one other shadow for the starfish, not on the starfish, but in the sand, that I want to get in before I start back on my water. So I'm going to use my flat brush and pick up a little bit of brown. Create some glaze. I want this to be really thin. And right here, it looks like the starfish kind of got moved and used to be right here. So there's a little place in the sand. Okay. Now that it's drying, it's looking pretty dull on the yellow part, so I'm gonna brighten that up. Just on these edges. Okay, now that's all I'm going to do to the starfish. So now I'm going to move on to my water. And for that, I'm going to use my little round brush because I want to get some bubbles in here. Okay, for the bubbles, I want almost... It's gonna have a hint of blue in it, but it's mostly brown. Maybe a little bit of white. Bubbles, I don't want to make like a perfect circle, and I don't want it to be completely outlined. I want to just kind of skip around, dab in a shape. These back here, I'm seeing more of the sand than I am here because this is so deep. So back here, I'm mixing up more of the sand color. Okay, now I'm gonna rinse the brush and this will take some time and some concentration, but I'm gonna pick up just white and on each of these bubbles we're gonna put bright. Make sure you get plenty of paint on your brush. Put a bright outline around it. Mostly on these right here in the deepest part of the foam, but some back there too. And I'm not perfectly outlining these, I'm just kind of dabbing in some bright white around them. Being a little more haphazard back here because it's not as detailed, but and I'm kind of skipping around and even between the little bubbles, tapping in some white, just don't think about it too much. I mean, you want to kind of get around those bubble areas, but then when you're tapping in white, just dab around. Don't think much about it because you can overthink it. Just dabbing in some white between my, where I don't have bubbles. If there's any places where I want it to be brighter, tap in some thick paint. I believe that's got it. You can come back with, I think I will, come back with my flat brush and put that dark shadow color like I did on the starfish, but put it under the water right here where it's the very darkest. Thank you. Every little detail like this is going to help add interest and realism to your painting. So even if something seems really subtle, do it anyway. Okay, I'm finished. I hope you like this one and give it a try. Like and subscribe to my channel. Check out my other videos. I've got lots of them on there. So until next time, thanks for watching. Bye, guys.